to you at a later meeting, the guidance and the Prudential code with some indications to show how we are applying that here and how we are taking the kind of, you know, the best practice elements of that and applying them locally, if that allows. Probably as much as I can say on that for the moment.
Well, just I don't know whether Cheryl was going to say something, but I'll leave you the last word for a refreshing change. And the thing for me, and it picks upon Steve's point really, that we need to know in terms of what happens if it fails. So what are the risks and what happens if it fails? And we need to make sure, I don't think we did make a start on this earlier on, but I think we as a committee, and also I think the council, need to be very clear about the risks that we're entering into and the potential consequences. And you'd be delighted to know, Steve, that all I talked about pretty well, but that's not quite true, but maybe half of what I talked about earlier on was about mitigations. So you'd be delighted, if you were there in spirit, if we were talking about mitigations.